If prostate cancer is diagnosed early, it is 100% curable. If it's diagnosed late, it can be 100% uncurable.
They say there's no symptoms, so you don't really know. So I was hoping it wasn't cancer. But on the other hand, if it was, I wanted them to be able to do something about it.
It is a disease that we have the ability to screen for using a blood test currently called PSA. This is not a very good test in the sense that it tells us something's going on in the prostate, but doesn't actually tell us what's going on in the prostate.
They went in and did biopsy, and they did put me on some more medicine, and they said, let's see where this takes you. It'll be 68 next month, and I'm glad I did it, because, you know, my dad died of cancer. So when I retired, I thought, well, I don't want to be 2 years out and die because of something stupid.
There was a recent study that dogs can sniff urine and can tell whether the patient has prostate cancer or not. So the big question that we are exploring is what is that smell? We collaborated with VA to get these urine samples.
We work with the urology clinic, and the veterans who are scheduled for a biopsy are invited to join the study and donate urine before their biopsy.
They said they were doing a study for IU, told me that they were doing it for the dogs to be able to sniff out prostate cancer. Kind of groundbreaking, you know.
We are already collaborating with a dog trainer in town who trains medical dogs. The idea is to verify the signature that we identified in the lab with dogs in the field.
We get our samples from Maggie and Amanda from IU. Once we have the samples, we present them to the dogs and we teach our dog to look for the specific sample that they need to detect. Everything is visually identical and the dog only has the option to use his nose to find the sample. The way that we have taught the dogs to indicate that they have found a sample in a can is to maintain their head inside the can until we dispense the treat.
Of course, like, we can do 100 things in the lab and we can say this is the biomarker. But if we know what signature it is and if we can verify that signature with a trained dog, then we feel that there will be a speedy acceptance of the results in the community.
We go to the VA, we pick up the urine samples, we bring them back to the lab, and then we incubate them with the polymer-based fiber, which is very good at collecting the scent of the urine onto the fiber, because our noses are not as good as the dog's.
So the end goal is to have a prostate cancer sensor that can be used in a doctor's office to test prostate cancer in real time. Since it's non-invasive, it just needs urine sample. So once we have this sensor, the goal is to increase widespread screening.
Work with sense is something that we're just on the beginning of understanding how important it is. And the next 10 years, we'll see a big explosion in this type of research.